Hello, this is Longest Day, and we're looking at Pitt versus GT 2015. I'm going to go ahead and try to do one take and one long series, so here we go. All right, so we're in our traditional setup. You can see the defense is traditional setup we're used to seeing. I'm going to go ahead and start this play off. It's a triple option. So you can see Toms is looking right here at this defensive end. And this linebacker, and you can see the defensive end is going on the inside, so he should pull it, and he does. He pulls it. This guy right here, the linebacker takes the quarterback, so he's going to pitch it, which is perfect. Perfect pitch. Get a block out here, and makes the lane for us to run. The inside, we keep wanting to go to the inside. You know, I'm wondering how many more yards we'd get back on the outside, but they know what they're doing a lot more than me. All right, so I do want to go back and look right here, the Mike linebacker. I'm going to say their Mike linebacker is definitely on the scale of UNC, Mike's linebacker, and not on the scale of like a Duke or a Notre Dame or Clemson. And you'll see one of the things he's doing. See how he's coming so deep and shallow right here? He's, you know, basically touching the defensive end. He's basically taking the B back. And what you would have seen a lot of other games, you'll see them, they'll take off through this area right here, and they'll end up right in here where this pitch man is, where the quarterback would be. So if you look where the trajectory would be, he'd be right about here, he'd be right about here, and would have made a tackle right there. So it's so important that we get a hat on him. And you can see they're pinching really hard on our off tackles right there, trying to keep their Mike linebacker clean, and he really is clean. That's why you do really well on that particular play. All right, keep on going. You can see here another triple option. Looking right here. This guy right here is taking the V-back. He keeps. This guy takes the QB. He pitches. And what ends up happening here is the safety comes up and is able to make the block. And you can see right here at the bottom of the screen, where basically it's a missed block right here. We have a block going on right here. But again, I do want to point out that we do actually get a hat on the Mike linebacker. We're pinching on the inside, but look right here. He gets a hat on the Mike linebacker, or at least engages him. And that's going to slow him down. All we have to do is slow him down or engage him, and allow us to get to the corner. But we've got to make all the blocks. All right. That was a difficult block to make. For the wide receiver. Wide receiver was basically taking the safety on that one, and the A-back was taking the corner. We'll look and see what we have. A little different setup right here. And go ahead and start this play off. And you can see it's not a counter option. It's like a speed option back the other way. And we'll see if we get our blocks. It's supposed to get a block right here. And we do see the block is supposed to happen on this guy. So we're not actually to able to take him out, but we slow him down. This guy is supposed to choose either the quarterback or the B-back, and he chooses the quarterback, and we get it out to the B-back. B-back hits the corner. One thing, I think this is Mike Landavis, is able to get a hat on this guy, which slows him down just enough to allow Marcus Marshall there to just get to the corner and get by him. So every block matters. The block right here matters because that's what springs it for a touchdown. And let's see who that is. Was that Ricky June? Every block matters. All right, so that's a touchdown. We'll go ahead and get through to the next offensive series. Right here. All right. It's going to be a pass play right there. Little play action. We'll see who bites. Little play action right there. That's going to be a triple option. You'll watch the safety right here pulling up right here. It's actually the backside safety that ends up getting in position right here. He gets in position to defend our wide receiver. But all of our balls seem to be a little underthrown, and he comes back great and does a great job. Glad to have Mike Summers back on the field. And you can see right here how the safety does a good job of picking them up. But it's just a little underthrown, and he can't get there man on man. So we end up making a great catch. All right, so You can see we have our wide receiver stepped up on the line. Nothing really else to talk about. You can see what the setup is. And this looks like it could be just a dive. And you can see, you know, Thomas may be reading something here, because this guy definitely goes to the outside right there. He goes to the outside. We give, and you see this is open. We're trying to get to the Mike linebacker right here. We're not able to quite get to him. And you can see that's the person who actually makes the stop right here. See anything else we can tell? Yeah. If this guy goes in and takes the V back, Thomas must be supposed to take it himself, because you can look, it's pretty clear. I mean, if he takes the V back, Thomas has a nice lane to go through. All right, keep on going. Let's see here. Thomas is reading right here. You can see like a cross charge going on, but they both take the B back. So Thomas is definitely going to keep it right there. They both take the B back. We have the safety coming up really hard. Safety coming up hard. And you can see right here, Mike Lands Davis's responsibility is the safety and not quite able to make that block. But Thomas sidesteps it right there. And there's no one else out here. So I'm trying to figure out where all the players are. I guess the cornerback is running his guy off. The Mike linebacker and the linebacker both come up to the middle. So they're both taking themselves out of the play. So this is the last guy to try to make a play. You can see right here, we just beat that. And we're able to make the first down, except for we end up fumbling the football. All right, we'll get to the next series. All right, here we go. Triple option. Both these guys, this guy, the inside guy right here, this defensive end, takes the B back. So Thomas pulls it. Thomas pulls it. This guy right here, you see how Thomas is attacking him? And he's attacking him, and he's trying to split the difference, so he just can't pitch it. But he makes him turn his shoulders. His shoulders are not turns towards the quarterback. So Thomas cuts it up, and that's what he's supposed to do. Now I want to point out Will Bryan right here. Watch this man right here do an incredible block right here. So he's being pinched on the inside, and again this Mike linebacker is playing shallow versus playing over here. He's playing shallow, but even with a pinch, when this guy plays shallow, Will gets past his block. Gets on the Mike linebacker. Watch him. Watch this guy just right here. Watch right here. Just push, pancakes him. Push him right on the ground. Incredible. Great. What I do worry about against FSU is you're going to see this Mike linebacker. He's going to shoot out here. And, of course, if they're shooting hard, the counter option should really kill him, unless they read the counter option right and they shoot hard in the direction of the counter option. So this Mike linebacker is going to be the key for FSU. I don't think they're going to play as shallow. They're going to end up going further to the outsides, which makes it a lot harder for our... See, right there, great block. Again, if he's faster, he would have been right about here. Right here. And instead of where he can be engaged. But incredible block by Will. Just great block. So, we got JT right there running. Just not able to make the touchdown, but a great play. Real excited right here. This is just incredible blocking. You got some, can't forget everybody else. We've got Shamir doing a block right there on the inside, looking good. And let's see who else we can see here. You can see him making, the shoulders are turned. He's past. It's hard to tell exactly where the players are unless they're directly behind or directly in front of the play. You can see clearly right here, Thomas is supposed to make the turn and run upfield. Okay, let's get to this next one. It's going to be a pass. I mean, very little play action right here. Blocking looks relatively good, so we have some time. Thomas has got an internal clock thinking he better throw this ball quick. And I guess basically, you know, he's thinking throw it short, and they're not on the same, you know, wavelength right there. I'm not sure exactly what's going on. But he's definitely thinking short, and he's not. So, all right, second and 10. You can see this blitz coming right here. Let's see if they pick up the blitz. Of course they do. We're delaying the snap, so it gives us some time to think. You can see Will Bryan jumps in there, takes the blitz, takes it out pretty good. And it's going to be this, like a power option. I call it a power option because you got this, instead of the V-back being a dive, he ends up being a blocker. And so you're kind of like speed optioning with the A-back instead of the B-back. So he makes a block right here on this, the Mike linebacker. See the Mike linebacker stepping over? See, 1, 2, 3, 4. So my linebacker steps over. Does a great block right there, exactly what he's supposed to do. Right here, he's not supposed to block this guy. He's supposed to block that guy. That's the pitch guy. We pitch it over. And we'll watch a block right here, it's supposed to happen. And although we don't put him on the ground, we push him to the outside, and we correctly run to the block side of the ball, which is where we're supposed to run. We do real good. One thing I do want to point out, look where Shamir Devine is downfield, so he is definitely playing his heart out. They all want to win. I know everybody is a little upset, but our guys are playing. They're playing, and they want to win just as much as everybody else. Let's see here. I'm seeing a lot of good things. Look how Burden there is getting off the ball. Look how quickly, how far he is. Going to try to put his hat right there. He does a great job of at least making the Mike linebacker react and slow down, which is what you want him to do. Okay, you can see JT is looking on his triple option. He's looking at this defensive end, which is inside, so he pulls it like he's supposed to. Look, he's going down, pulls it, but this guy actually does a good job of just kind of hanging back in there and waits on the edge, and he sees that the B-back doesn't have the ball. Goes after JT, so really he's really double covered. We make the pitch right here, and right here we've got to make him miss. We just got to get the ball and run, you know, pretty hard. This block right here is, you know, pushing to the outside, could open a seam, but you can see right here, we end up getting caught for a face mask. Just can't tell. You know, I was at the game, and the way it made his head look like he went down right there, so it looks like he has a face mask, but there it just looks like he just has his hand on his helmet. I don't see him grabbing the face mask and doing that. So, anyways, that's a big penalty for us. Triple option again. Let's see here. We're not quite able to make this block on the inside right here, but he doesn't get the ball anyways because this defensive end is pinching and staying on the inside. So that means JT's going to keep the ball. All right, so I think I'm forgetting to look at the Mike linebacker on these. We always got to look at those on triple options. So JT keeps the ball, and you have this outside linebacker who's supposed to take one of them. He takes the quarterback, so he pitch it out. Perfect. We don't really get really that much of a hat on this Mike, and you can see he's really slow. He's really watching the play. And if you watch, a lot of times the teams that give us the worst time is this guy really gets to the outside. And if I can explain, he'd be probably right about here, probably right about here, and probably right about here. So we'd have to beat him. So let's see what else is going on. See if we see other blocks going on. Got a block going on right here. What's that, Brad Stewart, who's actually taking on two guys. The safety is trying to come up. But you can see that's supposed to be was this Mike Land Davis's job to get to the safety. You can see the guy who actually makes the tackle ends up being a Mike linebacker. All right, we'll keep on going. You can see what was that, end of half or something. Second and 15, going to be a pass, and we just throw it up. And what is it, man on man? He's not giving him any cushion. So we think we're going to beat him on the outside. He stays with him. He gets a little by him, and he's turning around looking for the ball, and the other guy can't see it, and we just make the reception. So I can say in the past, our receivers have had a hard time, you know, if the ball got to him, actually making a reception. But if the ball usually gets to our receivers this year, it's been very, very pleasant that they're coming down with the receptions. Very impressive. So we'll go ahead and get to the next series. All right. So this is going to be what looks to be like a counter option, but it's not. It's just like this counter QB play that we have. And if you look, get a great block right here. So Trey Braun right here taking that guy down. We have Chamberlain running to the outside, doing a great job, doing a train right there. Let's see what else happens on the inside. One thing is, this Mike linebacker is fooled. I'm sorry, this outside linebacker is fooled. He's going in. He's really fooled right there. This Mike linebacker is fooled. So they take themselves out of the play. So you'll see this play later in the game, and it doesn't work so well. And I think it has to do with this guy right here. He comes around, and we're not able to block him. But this time around, they're definitely going the wrong direction. Pull around. JT makes some more great yards. Moving us on down the field. First and 10. Normal setup. Looks like we got some serious blitzing going on. They back up. But one good thing is we start the motion right as everybody's backing up. So no one's really ready to do what they're going to do. And let's see what this is going to be. This is just like the same play. If it's the same play. If you look, remember how this guy took himself out? This guy took himself out last time. He's not out. He's in. The other thing that happens is this guy is supposed to be hit. And I think that's what happened is this guy should be pushed out so we don't get our assignments quite right. And then his assignment is supposed to be this guy right here. And so it would open up a lane right here. We've got the safety coming up. That would have made this play harder too. Doesn't go for very much the opposite direction. All right. This is going to be a triple option. This guy goes in, he's taking a B-back right there. So JT keeps. The outside linebacker comes up, takes the quarterback. We pitch. Let's look at the Mike linebacker. Mike linebacker is coming through this area right through here versus coming through this area right here. And what he does, he's actually engaged by Will. Will gets a hat on him and is actually able to slow him down enough. And we're getting to the outside. The pitches happen really quickly, which is really good because the longer you string out the pitch, you know, if JT actually is running this way instead of this way, this is a much faster option. If you're going this way, it's a much slower option. It gives people time to react. So it's so fast, a fast pitch, the way it's supposed to be. We are making a block on the outside right here. Great job there. We don't put them to the ground. This inside move right here is pretty good. You know, should he go to the outside? And, you know, I just don't know. You're just not on the field with the guys. You can't trust a TV angle unless you're in front of or behind. You don't know what this guy is seeing and feeling. So be careful how hard you are sometimes on these guys because the angles can really fool you. We'll look at it right here. You're behind them right here. You'll see what's going on. So, should he have shot this gap right here? Could he have shot that gap? He's going back to the inside. It slows him down sometimes when they try to go back to the inside. And of course, I remember like Godhigh, he was the master of cutting back to the inside and seemed to be able to make a whole lot of yards doing that. So I just don't know. Counter option right here. So counter option, this Mike linebacker takes one hop really forward, not really out of the play. But it's just enough for us to, right here, we'll see who that is. Who's getting a hat on him? That's Will at least getting to him and slowing him down. So we'll see right there. This guy's job right here has got this pulling guard. It's supposed to take him out right there. And I think what's supposed to happen really is this guy is supposed to be the pitch man. Let's see what's blowing this up. Is it the safety? The safety stepped up and the safety's coming hard. We crack block on a safety. We don't hurt him. I remember Smelter would hurt some people. And we're supposed to have a block right there. I think it's just supposed to be a pitch and trust that this guy is going to beat this guy. Because basically what happens is, Tom's is running into some issues and he can't get to the pitch guy. And I think he's supposed to keep the ball if that's the case. because you don't want to lose yardage. All right. So let's see here. Anything remarkable? No. You can see it looks like there's going to be some definite blitzing going on. And they're really not showing it. You can see they're not showing it until the very last second. So we don't know what's happening. Let's see how well we do against it. And it's going to be a pass play. So it's not a good time to... Right there, I guess... I'm not sure how they know it's going to be a pass play. But it seems like they know it. You know, there's very little other times they do this. They go, look what they're doing. It's like they know it's going to be a pass play. That's very interesting. All right, so I just don't see this linebacker here normally going to the gap he does. So you just don't normally see that. So very interesting. We throw it, make the reception. Could have been the down. Let me see what down it is. Were they expecting it? It's first and 10. I don't know why they were expecting a second. Second and 10, really. Pass play. Great reception, by the way. Very impressive. Thomas also got the ball off with so much pressure in his face. Let's see what this is here. We're a little overloaded right here. Got this tied in right there. And it's just going to be a QB sneak right here. Let's see what happens. Yep. It's a QB sneak. All right. Looks like this guy is going to blitz. Will does a great job picking him up. Right there. It's going to be a triple option. We pull it. This guy is kind of going on the inside. He's pinching real hard right there on Chamberlain. You can see that. Look at Burden right there. Burden getting the hat. Awesome. Gets out there, gets a hat on the Mike linebacker, exactly what you want to do. All you do is have to touch him and hit him. And if you can do that, it slows him down. JT is going down the line, and look, he's trying to go through this area right here. If you remember, a lot of times we're bowing back and trying to go through the area right here. But he's going down the line, and he's trying to make that guy commit. Shoulders are kind of parallel to the line. We pitch it anyways. But I love, there's no hesitation in Lynch right there. You know, the hesitation, when you think you're going to be tackled, if you kind of pause or whatever, you're going to get hit. But there's no hesitation right there. We do a great job right here. Right here, we're running off. We don't even have to block, we're running him off. Got a block that has to happen right there. Lynch is cutting back to the inside. Does a great job cutting back to the inside and ends up making the first down. Great run. I'm having a hard time, you know, since I can't see from the front and the back every play, you know, wondering if these guys, especially when they get hit for a loss, because it looks like they're slowing down at times, trying to cut back to the inside, whether or not they should just go to the outside or cut back. All right, so one of the things Gove gets dinged for a lot of times is this right here. His head is already down. He's looking straight down at the ground, and he's kind of like diving over. Is there anywhere else he's supposed to go? And I think the block is happening right here that he's supposed to be reading. Block is there, block is there. Who ends up making the tackle is this guy right here. So the center comes out. He's not able to win that battle completely. And he ends up being the one that's kind of in the way that we're running over. So we'll do this again. Same thing. All right. So right here you can look, his head is going down. That's one of the things he's having problems with. He tries to cut through, just not able to get completely through. I will say this, let's watch here, see if we can see. Head is down, but he is fighting hard. He is a fighter. Just worried about that ball. Oh gosh, the grip on that ball. Now watch this. His head is up. His head is up. He bounces to the outside. Instead of trying to go through this hole right here, he bounces to the outside. See right there? Of course, I wonder if he would have made it either way. But it bounces to the outside and right in the end zone. All right, let's keep on going. Touchdown, touchdown. We're ahead. We're tied. All right. Here we go. First and 10. Looks like they're going for a pass play. So, you know, they're not reading our passes. You can see here it's not a pass play, but they're definitely heading in to do some damage. And this is, gosh, what happens? It's just too many people. You can see right here, there's just too many going into that gap. So we have Burden just takes right here. And you can see right here, we just go in, get to the quarterback. What happens if he doesn't get to the quarterback? Oof, look at that, wide open. Who is left to block? This guy has got to be blocked. This guy has got to be blocked. The problem is, there's no one to take this extra guy. Yeah. I'm not sure who's supposed to block. You know, it'd be nice if Braun could have hit him, but Braun is supposed to take this guy right here. This is who he's supposed to take right there. So if he doesn't take him, it's just one extra guy. Can't tell you that anything went wrong there other than they did a great job. That's a great strategy. But if it blows up, if you miss, it's going for a house call, that's for sure. So second and 13. Just a rocket toss. Let's see what happens here. You know, it's a pretty split. This guy is a little closer on this side. Let's see what happens here. You can see he doesn't fly up. He's taking a step back. So that's very helpful. You know, a lot of times what happens, this guy's flying up. All right. If he was flying up, that would have been you know, pretty tough on us. You can look right here. This guy gets through. Let's see what happens here. Great run. They didn't diagnose that play very well. We did a good job executing. We're going to toss it the other direction. So we'll look at the safety. It's the one who normally blows us up. Ceiling right there. Great job. Trying to get away to this guy right here. We jump a little early, so he had a chance to defeat that block, but he actually goes down. We're getting by this block a little bit. Let's see who that is. Is that Will? Right there. And we're just not... You just got to get to the outside. You can see here, you know, Clint Lynch, I love him, and I've said it so many times. He's got great hands. He's done the triple option so well. The rocket toss has gotten him several times because he's really always looking for that inside right here. Now, I mean, to his defense, too, the block looks like he should run to the inside, and he ends up not being able to make it. I'm not sure exactly what's supposed to happen here. If he runs to the outside, this guy gets him right here at the line. So it's just not well blocked. Not exactly sure, you know, why we would leave this guy completely unblocked. Very interesting. All right. Something might have been a little wrong with the blocking scheme on that play. Okay, so they're doing this inside thing here again. You see right here? Let's see what happens. All right. He misses Thomas. You can see that inside, we block, comes through. Looks like it's going to be, this is speed option right here. He's taking the B-back. Remember last time, he took the quarterback on the speed option. And look, I love it, JT. All the people on the boards, right there, that's just awesome. Just got to be quick. Right there. Love it. We got Mike Land Davis pushing that guy to the outside right there. Got to beat one person. But it ends up, you know, when he slows him down a little bit, ends up being hit a little bit by the guy in the back. All right. Third and one. And we make it. First and 10. Going to be a pass play. But let's see here. Just everybody's coming. The whole house is coming. So you wonder who's not supposed to be blocked here. Blocker. You got 2-on-1 right there. So we're getting away from our block right here. Not good. End up back, got a flag. First and 10. Just no one's open. All he is just trying to run out the time. If no one's clearly open, you want to keep the ball. I wonder, you know, right here. I can't tell. I wish I could have seen that guy was open. They're not going to show it again. Another one right there. We're just going to throw it out of bounds. 11 seconds. Third down to go. Third and 8. Timeout. Just a real quick play. Just something. Not open. End up trying to kick it. Let's see what happens. And he's going through right there. Who actually blocks it, though? It's this guy right here. Only thing I think is possibly is it low? Runs out the time of the clock. Let's see who blocks it. Right here. Let's see what happens. This guy, who's he engaged first? It's hard to tell. Looks like he could be engaging Brian first. It's hard to tell from this angle. So you basically have these guys right here. They push. It is a low one. Well, keep on going. The ball will start the second half here. Looks like I missed a play. And it's just going to be a rocket toss. So, sealing off the end here. Sealing off the linebacker. Sealing off this guy. And again, we leave this guy unblocked. So a little different than what I'm used to seeing. All right. It's going to be just a looks like it's going to be like a QB follow or maybe a midline. Is that what it's supposed to be? Let's see here. This guy's unblocked. That guy's blocked. I don't know, it looks like it's going to be, you know, a midline or something like that, but we end up giving it to him where the spacing is. Normally a midline, though, this guy is blocked. Might be the location of this gentleman right here. Anyways, we go through. One thing to look at is what's going on right here. A good block right there. Who ends up making the block? Or right there, he ends up making the stop. Is it 3rd and 1? These guys are stepping up. It's just going to be a QB follow. End up making the first down. All right, keep on going. You see right here, they're treating it, was it 5 on the line? So we're not blocking. We end up not blocking this guy right here. So we don't block him. He ends up taking the, I guess we're going to treat, oh, we're treating him, basically it's these two guys. I'm sorry. It's these two guys. He takes the B back. That's all that happens. This guy steps up on the line, and he's going to make Thomas pitch it quick, which is perfect. I do say right here, we're engaging. We get to the Mike linebacker right there. Excellent. Got to get to that Mike linebacker. I mean, our season will go with our ability to get that Mike linebacker. All right. Get to the Mike linebacker. Kind of make a block. You can see this corner is firing right here. Fires too far on the inside. Get a nice block right there so we can pick up some yards. We've got a block going on downfield. This guy's taking the safety. You can tell it right there. And end up making some good yards. All right. Here we go. Same thing. This guy takes the B back. Right there. This guy is coming on the inside, but it's too late. Well, I mean, I guess the slip right there, Thomas goes ahead and decides to pitch it. If you see it in real time, it looks like Thomas, you know, is going to go ahead and run. And I think that's what's going on. It still looks like the pitch relationship's a little messed up. And I don't think he's expecting it. I think he's expecting Thomas just to run right here. But he pitches it out. And that hurts us right there. Second and 16. All right. Did we make everything else on that one? Let me just check real quick. Go back and look. So did we get to the mic? The mic takes himself out. Again, we're not going to get this luxury all the time. Definitely got to get to this mic. But he ends up taking himself out of the play right there. And if we pitch it right there, if we catch it, you know, get the edge, we're going to make some yards. All right. Pass play. Actually, it's going to be a QB draw. And let's see what happens. They're doing this inside thing. I mean, they're just going to ram it down our throats. And they close down the middle. You'll watch right here. That's what they've been doing during the game. Not only that, we're just not able to hold our block here. Oh, goodness. They called the right play at the right time, that's for sure. Mike linebacker's blitzing in. Right there, not able to get him. Two guys really free. I guess it's the turn the wrong way. I'm not sure. Ends up stopping this. So it's basically two pass plays. One play that we had a bad pitch. And then one play where we were doing a QB draw, and they called the right defense at the right time. And then another pass play, and they blitz us and make it through. So that's what stops this drive. They're definitely, you know, second and 16, they're pulling off their pass rush type plays. So I think this is where they get ahead of us for the first time. Think. Let's see what happens here. No. We have the ball. All right, first and 10. Defense stops. Great. You can see right here, they're going to send this guy rushing in right here. This is going to be a pass play right here. You have this rocket toss looking thing. This guy is definitely not buying it. They're looking for a pass. I don't know why they're looking for a pass. Is it the motion? Is there something else that happens? Is that what happens on the line? These guys are backing off really hard. Even this guy is backing off. They're looking for a pass. Just not quite get to it. All right. So what does Paul Johnson see? What are they doing? These guys are stepping up close. Is that what it is? So this guy backs off, and it's just a hard throw. We just don't get back to it. But you know, if we make that reception, that changes a lot right there. We get a hand on it. It's just hard thrown. Just not able to get to it. Difficult. All right. This looks like just a triple option with the blitz going on right there. And I guess with the blitz, what happens, the safety comes up to fill the hole from the blitz. And he's looking for the Mike linebacker, but it's going to be a triple option. And we give right because these two guys, they go to the outside, so the give is the right read. Just the safety stepping up to make the stop. So that series, you know, the first two pass plays didn't work. So go ahead and get to the next one. I think this is the one where they make their points. And we come back. We'll do this drive and we'll call it in. All right. Triple option. Both guys go to the outside. Outside, outside. So it's a give read. Give read. Watch Shamir Devine. Shamir Devine ends up taking the Mike linebacker. Look at Will Bryan getting in there. Seals it off permanently right there. Bam. Great right here. Marcus Marshall running down. I don't know. I wonder if he... It's hard to tell exactly if he slows down, but great with the hand right there. Pushes that guy away. Great block. Blocking is winning right here. Great block. All right. See what happens here. I thought for sure they were going to call us on this step right there. There's a little step right there. They don't. Thank goodness. ends up going to be a triple option. Let's see here. Is it a triple? It's a weird triple. These guys are going to the inside. Okay, I think Thomas doesn't give because this guy's going to the inside. And so he keeps it. And that's good because he ends up taking the B-back. So Thomas is excellent reading right there. It's just weird what hole he's going through. They're pulling where they're going through the center hole right there, trying to get to the quarterback quickly. And this guy steps up, and Thomas has to think so fast. Again, he's going down the line, not backwards, makes the quick pitch. Perfect. And what happens is this safety is also flying up in this direction instead of out here. And that takes him out of the play. So that's perfect. Making a block right there. You know, I figured this could possibly went for more yards, but it pushes it to the short side of the field. Make some good yards. All right, keep on going. Let's see here. So linebacker steps up on the edge. It's going to be a triple option. He's going to pull it because this guy's going in. And it's just it's not enough time. Is it going to be a QB follow? Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a QB follow because look what this A-back is doing. He's going on the inside. And he's supposed to follow him up the hole, but I don't know exactly. Thomas didn't give it. Either way, something did not work out right. This guy is just getting there so fast. I think it's the speed at which this guy got in, and we're not able to get a block on him. So that made all the difference in the world in that particular play. Third and five. Rocket toss. So let's see here. These guys are rushing the center again, trying to get to Thomas real quick. But with the rocket toss, it's kind of perfect. You can see right here, we did a lot in the tight set. I wish we would have ran a little bit more at the end. Of course, we're at the end, basically. We did pretty successful in this set. You can see we're cracking him. We're getting to the outside right there. And we're going to have to run to the inside. We're not even blocking this guy right here. So we're going to have to find an inside lane because this guy's going to stop us. And Lynch finds the inside lane. Does a good job there. Let's see if does he slow down? He cuts and goes. He's not really slowing down. He cuts and goes. So ends up making some positive yardage. First and goal. And we're just going to go with basically a dive. That's what it looks like to me. You can see right here, everybody's going to the outside. Let's see here, everybody's running to the outside. So all these guys are really going hard in this direction. And the actual play, instead of like, you know, most of the times we do a triple option, it's in this direction where the dive is going. Well, this play, it actually goes right up the center. right up the center, right there. Perfect. Oftentimes, I find these referees are annoying in that they're getting in the way. So instead of moving like they need to move, they're like standing in the way. Let's see here. Any good blocks? Great block. Great block on the inside. Block right here. Great play. 28-28. All right, they get the ball, and we get the ball back. So, chance to go up on them. 10 minutes left in the quarter here. Let's see what happens. This looks like it's supposed to be a triple option, and it looks like just basically a bad read. This guy is going in, unless it was a called dive. I forgot. Let's go back here. There's one more play here. So, we're in our tight set right here, both wide receivers in, and we're giving it right there to the B-back. So it's the same play. Remember last time everybody went that direction. This time it looks like everybody's going this direction. It's really interesting. It goes right where it's supposed to go. Excellent. We got one more block to make. We're bouncing it to the outside. Does a great job. He does have this feet thing right there. It's really interesting. Breaks, tries to push through that tackle right there. It's done a great job. The guy's able to rip the ball out, gets back on it. Scary moment. All right. We go back, and you know, I don't know if it's a called dive, but I'm looking. Will's trying to get, you can see Will Bryan trying to get by right here. Getting the like linebacker. I think it's just a bad read. Yeah, everybody's going to the right places. It's just a bad read. This guy's going in, ends up, and I think we get beat on our block probably right there too. So 2nd and 10. All right, got a blitz going on here. Linebacker steps on the outside again. Ends up being, looks more like just a dive. You know, I can, you know, if you look right here, this guy definitely comes on the inside right there, and he's the one who ends up making the tackle. So it's very interesting right there. Now we make 3 yards, but now it's 3rd and 7 because the first one didn't go very far. So we're behind schedule. Going to be a pass play. And we catch it. And one of the problems is, I think right here, we end up, is it beyond 5 yards right here? We end up hitting this guy before the pass is caught. They throw the flag on us. Where are we at? We're on R30. We don't make the first down. So would we have gone for it? I don't know. Perhaps we would have kicked the ball further, that's for sure. But 3rd and 20 after the penalty. And ends up being it could be just a triple option. Could be just a call dive. It's really hard to tell. This guy is definitely headed to the outside. And so ends up making it right there. 4th and 13, we kick it. So they're 30. There's really no sense in playing the last. I mean, we get 1 minute and 15 seconds, I think, to make it. We make a couple of. We're not able to move it down the field. Anyways, there's a lot of good about this. I saw a lot of good blocking. Saw a lot of players that I'm excited about: Mike Lane Davis, Marcus Marshall, Will Bryan. JT still can work his moves when everybody else is doing their job. We put our hat on the Mike linebacker. Again, I do worry about it going into FSU. That Mike linebacker is going to be flying to the outside pretty hard. And they're going to be able to ignite, diagnose pretty quickly. So I don't know if we'll have as much success against FSU. We'll see. Of course, you know, FSU lost a lot of defensive people, and maybe they're not quite as good as they've been in the past. I'll post up probably a series or two from last year's games for everybody to look at. But overall, the offense is looking much better. They looked, you know, just as good as UNC. Again, you know, Duke really had a great defense. Notre Dame had a great defense, and Clemson had a terrific defense. Those are games that I expect would have given us significant problems. Where Duke didn't have the offense, I was hoping maybe our defense could step up and prevent them from making more points than we could. Didn't happen. Of course, our offense couldn't do a lot against that defense. Notre Dame, I think, a little dazzling. Defense played really hard and tried to keep us in the game because the offense really couldn't get it going. And they were on the field a lot, and they put a lot of heart into it. Very impressed there with the heart that went into it. Gave us a chance to win. And then UNC, up by 21, and you know, our offense wasn't able to keep up with their scoring, and we ended up losing that. That was a definite winnable game for us. And then Clemson, they really took us to the woodshed. We that was a difficult place to play. I was at the game on Saturday, and there was times when we had the ball in the stadium. I mean, when we were on defense and the stadium was completely silent, you know, there wasn't much of a home field advantage for much of the game for the Jackets. Just the noise level was very low. Not even saving the student section there in the third and fourth quarter, the noise level was very low for our defense. And, you know, a lot of times the defense can really feed off the crowd. And if the crowd can really be the 12th man, again, I'm not just disparaging our fans. I think everybody was kind of feeling the same thing, that they were feeding the team, and the team was feeding the crowd the sense of possible despair, like, you know, this is going to end in the wrong direction, versus everybody cheering and on their feet and, you know, willing us ourselves to win, both the crowd and the team. You just could feel the despair a little bit, that, you know, this is not going to happen. It was almost like the Middle Tennessee game we did a couple years ago. Felt just like that after the big Miami letdown that we had. That we had that game and we went playing Middle Tennessee and we ended up dropping to them too. Really hope at the FSU game we at least can be a factor. Could be a 12th man that people will really yell. And I know I'm sitting on the wrong side, the wrong spot. I'm sitting with all the old alumni, and I'm hearing people telling people to sit down because they paid to see the game too. And I'm just like, gosh. Anyways, I really hope we can be the 12th man this team needs to hear why they're on defense and really cheer them on. All right, that's all I got. If you're still listening, wow. I can't believe it. But I hope you got some entertainment value from it. All right, bye.